Federal High Court in Abuja has ruled that the former Minister of Finance, Kemi Adeosun, was not eligible for a mandatory one-year national service. The court, presided over by Justice Taiwo Taiwo, said she was not obliged to present herself for the National Youth Service, which is the NYSC mobilization, under the 1979 Constitution, as she was not a Nigerian citizen at the time of her graduation or when she turned 30. According to the ruling, the Constitution does not require her to present the first degree certificate or any other document, including discharge or exemption for a political appointment. And so her ministerial appointment was not illegal, neither was it unconstitutional, even without presenting the NYSC certificate. Well, to break this all down, joining me to discuss is Biodun Showomi and Achuke Chude, both public affairs analysts. Thank you very much, gentlemen.
It's my pleasure.
Great. So I'm going to start with you, Biodun. She wasn't a Nigerian citizen at the time, the statement says, of her graduation, and even before she turned 30. So I'm trying to understand, yes, maybe she wasn't holding a Nigerian passport or she schooled abroad, but this judgment is exonerating her on that basis. But there were other claims, you know, other than the fact that she didn't do her NYSC, there were claims of forgery. Is that also being struck off by this court judgment, by the Federal High Court?
Thank you for that. We need to remember one thing. Ms. Adeosun went to court to seek for constitutional interpretation of the 1979 Constitution, whether it applied to her or not. The court held that the 1979 Constitution, which did not recognize dual citizenship, you know, prescribed the NYSC strictly, you know, to be undertaken by Nigerians only. So therefore, by virtue of the 1979 Constitution, when, you know, she graduated, she wouldn't have been eligible. You know, that's a very straightforward matter. And the second angle to the question is the fact that the issue of forgery was not before the court. That was not before the court. Don't forget, Ms. Kemi Adeosun went to the court through a counsel, Wole Olanipekun, to seek for constitutional interpretation. She was not tried, arraigned by the Nigerian police force before the criminal justice system in any form. So therefore, the simple point of law which she sought the court to clarify.
Are you still there, Mr. Showomi? Let's go to Achuke. Achuke, I want you to take it from where he stopped. Yes, I understand clearly that this is what she went to court for, but there was a certificate in the mix which was not given or issued directly by the NYSC. She has been exonerated that the Constitution does allow her to be a minister legally in the country. But what about the case of forgery, even though it's not before the court?
Yeah, when, you know, sometimes, you know, when you have this kind of issues, it's only the court that can have the final say. Of course, we know that was why, you know, she sought the interpretation of the court, and the court has spoken. But she was not removed as minister. She not resigned as minister. Don't forget that she resigned, you know, on her own. She was not sacked as minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. I think the claim, you know, through her lawyer was that she did not want to be, she did not want the government she served to be distracted, you know, by, you know, the allegations that were swirling around her, you know, so she resigned. And so that is what the court looked at and said, look, you had really had no business resigning at that particular point in time. But because, again, I think she wanted to preserve her dignity as a person, and she didn't want that situation to continue to dog her. But beyond that, again, is that the major reason why the whole controversy started in the first place was because of the allegation of forgery. Unfortunately, she has not been cleared or vindicated over that allegation. You know, I'm not sure anybody has.
I was about to ask if somebody has taken that case to court.
I mean, if the court were to look into that. Yeah, go on.
Are I think we're having connection issues and I think there's a delay. But you can go ahead. I was just only trying to say that I do not know and I'm not aware of any court case in terms of the forgery. But of course, she went to court just to clarify the fact that, you know, the constitution did not apply to her and the fact that, you know, her ministerial appointment was not illegal. But you were saying something, so I didn't want to distract you.
Yeah, I think what would have happened really is that, it means that whatever certificate was produced could not have been an authentic certificate in the first place because she didn't even need it. And then it is the process of getting that certificate. If you remember, the NYC came in at the time they were having these contradictory, you know, statements and all that. But I think basically she could not have resigned if she knew that she was in the right. That is the way I read the whole of these things. Of course, the court has declared that she never needed it in the first place. But it was produced on her behalf as having come from the stable of the NYC. And that was contentious because at the time the NYC now weighed into it. And after some, you know, back and forth about whether it was released from them or not, it became clear that it could not have come through the normal process at the NYSC. Well, perhaps the court has spoken on this matter of whether she was entitled, she was, you know, the constitution allowed her to become a minister to remain a minister. The court says has ruled in her favor. But whether the issue of, forgery, if it had been instituted against her, whether she would have won it is very, very contentious. It is very, very likely that she would have lost that particular case if that had been the case.
Okay, let me go back to Biodo Shomi. Let's look at how this impacts on the politics of Nigeria and, you know, office holders, because this, some people would say, was a political witch hunt. Some other people would say that, if she left no stone unturned, she probably wouldn't have found herself in this mess. But we see things like this happen. And I'll give you another example. The former Minister for Communications also had a case of, his NYSC. And recently, we've heard people try to kick against the National Youth Service Corps. You know, some people have advocated for it to be banned. What role does it really play politically in running any office, having an NYSC certificate?
Well, when you look at this very particular situation, if it's required by law, by the NYSC Act, that people must undergo the NYSC service, then it's important for us to ensure that we do that if you are still within the cutoff age, you know, range of participating in it. And when you look at this very particular case, I really sympathize with Kemi Adeosun because what she has tried to do with this legal interpretation is to deodorize, you know, the fact that she was forced to resign. It's more or less like humiliated out of service because you cannot have a minister of finance, you know, being accused of forgery and the document tendered. And not only that, the issuing authority denied issuing that to her. So that was a major issue. It was very compelling for her to resign. And I thank her for that. And I think she did very well, you know, to take some responsibility and resign. But to now come back and attempt to deodorize, you know, the situation, you know, present herself in a different way, she will still need to make sure that the allegation of forgery is cleared. And that can only be done by the criminal justice system. It cannot be done through interpretation of the constitution, but it can only be done through being processed through the criminal justice system. This case is totally different from the case of Professor Adenike Grange, the former Minister of State for Health, who was caught up in an issue involving money with Iyabo Obasanjo and all that when she was a senator over a trip to Ghana. The woman was eventually cleared of all the allegations in court. That's totally different. In this case, she has not been tried. She only went before the court to seek an interpretation of the 1979 Constitution as it applied to her, but not about the issue of forgery. So therefore, I think it's important we understand that the case is not actually about NYC certificate or not being having NYC certificate. The case was actually about possession and presentation of a forged document from the NYC, you know, in the process of securing an appointment. Of course, we now know that she didn't need to do that in the first instance. So why then go ahead and forge a document if, as alleged she did, if indeed it's true? You know, that's the major issue which led to her resignation.
Back to you, Chike, in closing, she claims this as a victory for her and many Nigerians in diaspora. So just like Mr. Sowumi has said, she went to a court for an interpretation, not necessarily to exonerate her on the grounds of forgery. Is this a victory worth celebrating in that regard?
No, it is in a way you could say that the judgment was favorable to her in a way, but not all the way. Because again, the basis of the entire controversy that surrounded her was the basis of accusation of certificate forgery. It was on the basis of the controversy that followed that led her to resign. So, but if there was something positive anybody would have said about her, was that action of resignation, because it is usually, it is, you know, against the Nigerian character. You know, we wish that more Nigerian politicians, when they get embroiled in controversies like this or other controversies, would also go the whole way, the whole hog, and resign. And that stood her in good stead among a lot of Nigerians. So from that perspective, yes, she would have, a typical politician that is caught with stolen meat will shout from now till to high heavens that he did not steal anything, even though you see it on his hands. You know, he will fight all the way using the resources of the state, which are stolen in the first place, to try to exonerate himself, even when it is clear that he's guilty. She did not do that. And so that was unusual, maybe because of her background and where she's coming from, where, you know, there is a dignity attached to the office that they occupy. And so when you have this kind of controversy, you try to leave the stage. But beyond that, you know, the issue of forgery has not been, because that's not what the case is all about. And I think she should just go and relax and bask in the glory of this particular victory that said she had no, you know, reason resigning. But if somebody had taken her on, that's the question we should ask ourselves. Would she stand scrutiny with regards to the certificate that was given to her as a discharge certificate by the NYSC? So if I'm the one, I would advise her to let sleeping dogs lie. Otherwise, okay, that matter can be resurrected and it might not turn out favorably, it might not turn out in her favor.
All right, well, Biodo Sowumi is a political analyst, and of course, Chike Trude, also a public affairs analyst. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for being part of the conversation. We appreciate it.
It's my pleasure.
All right. Well, thank you all for staying with us on the program tonight. It's been a very interesting conversation that we've had from the beginning to the end. I'll see you tomorrow with brand new stories on politics. I am Mary Anacol. Thank you for watching.